do. Welcome to another Northeast 10 Conference Championship production right here on the PAC Network. Alongside Jacob Van Ren, I'm Matt Janik. We're here at Martone Mahail Field today. It's the 2012 Northeast 10 Conference Field Hockey Championship. The top seed, the Merrimack College Warriors, and the third seed, the University of Massachusetts Lowell Riverhawks.
Bianca Jones maintains control for the Riverhawks. She breaks through a couple defenders down the left side. Jones trying down the left sideline, throws it towards the front of the net. Bergquist gets a piece of it, now it's through the goal mouth. Nobody can get a stick on it. Ball comes into Wilcox, she winds and fires. Bergquist kicks it aside, but it falls into the middle. Wilcox trying to get her. Rita sends it across the front. I couldn't see him stuff it in on the far side. That looks to be number three, Vanessa Kent. I think got her stick to the ball to poke it across the line. Trouble getting it out of its own end here early on.
Yeah, their defense is having a real struggle to have the ability to clear the ball in our first half thus far.
That ball comes into the middle again. Looks like it was knocked aside. I think Dunbar was the one who got there to keep it out of the Merrimack. This comes in on the near side. Brought across to McCarthy, top of the circle. She winds, fires, and it's knocked down by the defense. We'll see if she can use that speed here down the left wing side. She takes it into the circle on the left side, flips it out front, kicked aside by Bergquist. Efforts tries to track it down. She fires, but it's blocked by the defense.
That's halftime here in North Andover. The Riverhawks 1 and Merrimack 0. And if you're Vanessa Kent sends it in to McCarthy. McCarthy winds, fires, but it's knocked aside by the defense. Good work by Abby Stacy to get out on that ball. Bianca Jones has it taken away. Nice step up there by Abby Stacy. Stacy sends it to Doherty on the left side. She sends it towards the middle, slapped away by the Lowell defense, but right back to Doherty. She winds, tries to get a shot off. Jones there to get a piece of it. It comes back out to Spano. And then broken up and finally sent away. A little ping-pong action there in the circle. Serves it into McCarthy. McCarthy, high riser towards the net. Ends up on the top of the cage. That really fooled Kerry Bergquist. Not what she was expecting at all. So the Riverhawks will take it back towards the offensive end. This is McCarthy dipsy-doodling around a defender. Steps towards the circle, falls, throws it towards the middle. This is Freitas who gets a shot off, but it goes wide. Now Hassel draws the foul, and she'll restart quickly. Doherty into the middle, just wide outside the left-hand post. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. The Lowell sideline storms onto the field. They are the three-time in a row champions now. It's a three-peat for the Riverhawks. Your 2012 Northeast 10 Conference Field Hockey Champions, the University of Massachusetts Lowell. They jump up and down in the center of the field.
The most outstanding player award for the 2012 Northeast 10 Championship is presented this afternoon to Sarah Wilcox from UMass Lowell. Now the 2012 Northeast 10 Field Hockey Champions, the UMass Lowell Riverhawks. Will the captain please step forward to accept the trophy?
And as Shannon Liebichuk said before, winning never gets old, and you can tell all smiles there from the four Riverhawk captains. They are the Northeast 10 champions. That's the third time in a row for Massachusetts Lowell. They win 1-0 over Merrimack.
2012 championship MVP, Sarah Wilcox joins me. First of all, congratulations, young lady,
on
this
win. Thank you very much.
Let's talk about this game. I guess your smile says a lot. You got a goal early on, and your defense made it hold up. Talk about this contest.
Getting the goal in the beginning was awesome, but it was a lot of pressure on our defense, especially we have a freshman back there. We have a sophomore, junior, and myself, and we just locked it down. We're good under pressure, so we came up with a win. But the goal in the beginning was really what put us over the top.
Your coach said that you were undoubtedly the leader of this team, especially on that half of the field. Talk about that role, and especially leading in some of the underclassmen, because by and large, you guys are a young team, just four seniors on this roster.
Our underclassmen are great. They listen to us, and that's all we can ask. And they're very coachable, and they've improved so much. And putting a freshman as our center defense in that game was amazing. And she has been under pressure, but not that kind of pressure, and it was amazing to see her step up.
I will say this. It's now three in a row. You've been here for all three of them. Does it ever get old?
No, it never gets old, especially coming in the three seed, taking off the top seed at their home field was awesome.
In terms of this win, you'll now look forward to an NCAA title, yet you celebrate an NE10 title here today. Give us a little preview as you look forward to a week from now when the NCAA tournament gets underway. I imagine you've made a few championship appearances. That's the goal, getting back there this year.
Obviously, that's our goal every year. I get to the national championship. This was just icing on the cake, but we're going to work hard for two more weeks, and hopefully we're back in the national championship game.
Congratulations. Go
celebrate. Thank you.
coached three in a row, I imagine this never gets old.
No, it absolutely doesn't, because every year is a new year. We have new players and new faces and people in new positions just working just as hard. So it's fun to win with a new team every year.
Talk about this win, obviously getting that goal early on, and then your defense, which has been the strength of your team all year long, made that one goal hold up. Talk about their performance on that side of the ball.
Yeah, no, we talked about that. We know that Merrimack is the most attacking team in the Northeast-10 Conference, so we were going to have to be really disciplined on defense to shut down their opportunities. And we talked a lot about it this morning, and I think we held to our game plan, and they did a fantastic job of being disciplined and composed.
I know that coaches don't like to single anyone out yet. That being said, I'll single out Sarah Wilcox. I thought she was sensational again defensively. Just talk about her play.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I know we talked a little bit about her before the game, but she's one of those people that wants to win. She loves to win more than she hates to lose. Or wait, what's that? Is the opposite? Sorry, is this live? She hates to lose more than she loves to win. But at the end of the day, it's her senior year. She wanted to go out with a championship. She's been tasting this since her freshman year and wanted to make sure that she made her mark on this program, and she absolutely has.
Three straight now for you. It was a little bit different having to go through, obviously, three teams en route to an NE10 title. You knock off a very good Merrimack team again. Talk about the game and getting that goal early, and just from a mental perspective, what that did for your team's confidence. You said early on you have to take some chances. You took some, and you capitalized on a good opportunity.
Yeah, absolutely. I thought we had to take some risks offensively, and we did that, and I thought we got a couple good looks, not a lot of opportunity. Kudos to Merrimack's defense. I thought they did a fantastic job. But, you know, we talked about it before. It only takes one, and we just needed one today and then to hold it down. So I think all over the field we just did a great job of sticking to our game plan.
Go out there and celebrate with your team. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks, Jacob.
You're very welcome.